is Paul Yeboah. I'm the founder of Ghana Permaculture Institute. I'm also a council member of Gen Africa. And you know, I started working with my parents on farm in a very rural area in Ghana. And I developed much interest in permaculture. So somewhere in the year 2004, I joined the permaculture design course, working at the Cristo Boise Monastery in Techiman. And then from there, the monastery started using chemicals on their farm. So I sent my resignation letter to them that I won't work with them because I hate using chemicals on the environment or growing crops. So from there, I developed much interested working with the farmers and then developing permaculture. And then somewhere 2008, you invited me to come to Germany, Zeebelenden, to take part in the Ecovillage Design Educational Course for 1 month. So this is a little bit about me.
Wonderful. And how are the communities in Ghana doing at the moment in the face of corona?
Yes, the communities in Ghana, most especially in Accra, Kumasi, Tamale, and then eastern part in the northern Ghana, are having some problems about the coronavirus issues. But we have partial lockdown in Ghana. And this partial lockdown is 2 weeks. And the government is doing his best to see how he can control the system. And I know that it's a global issue. So when you come to my community, you know, we also have a very good measures in place whereby we are trying to educate people to eat healthy food to boost their immune system. People continue washing their hands. And also people also to try as much as possible not to moving around, but they have to stay at home. And then again, trying to sanitize your hands, wash your hands. So we have a whole lot of washing hands in place in my community, where any corner people go there and wash their hands. And then also we are trying that people take moringa, 1 teaspoon every day, just to boost your immune system. So this is what is going on in my community in Ghana.
That sounds fantastic. And, you know, I've been to the center and I've seen all the amazing things that you do. And at the moment, I think so many communities are realizing in the face of the crisis how dependent they are on local food resources. And you have built up so much to make your community really resilient in terms of local food. So maybe you can just share with us a bit about what you are growing, producing, and also processing in terms of food.
Okay. When you come to my community, we are into essential oil distillation, which nowadays, because of this COVID-19 issue, people are trying to sanitize their hands. But we are using essential oil from citronella, lemongrass to sanitize our hands, which is well processed in our community. And again, we are also into biogas. We are also into solar system. And then we are also into processing moringa oil and then baobab oil, neem oil, and also into cosmetics from moringa cream, moringa ointment, moringa shampoo. And then we are also into tree nursery. This tree nursery, we are actually working on indigenous tree species that we have in Ghana. We are collecting the seeds from them, and then we have an area where we are setting up the nursery and then giving some of the seedlings to communities in Ghana, giving some of the seedlings also to schools in Ghana. And then we are also planting more trees in my community, just to combat the climate change in my community. So in a brief, this is what I'm doing in my community. We have rainwater harvesting also in place. A whole lot of things. Mushroom is also in place, where we are trying to recycle a lot of waste in the community for it to become a resource in the community.
Beautiful. And I know this is only a fraction of what you actually do. You could have
yes.
done much more. But yes. at least we're getting some of the ideas, and also that a healthy community really grows bottom up. It's a healthy relationship to the soil. And you have built that in your community and around you in many other communities. But as you already started saying, you've also faced the results of climate change already. And you have been responding to that. Could you just share a bit more about how climate is changing in northern Ghana and what the actions are that you have taken?
Okay. When you come to Ghana, the climate change is very rare because there is a very high temperature, which wasn't as we can see nowadays. And also bushfires and also erratic rainfall. The rainfall are not falling in the normal way, the way it rains of late. And again, there is a very strong winds and then big tender storms, very, very tender storms everywhere. And then strong winds, which are taking people's roof and a whole lot of issues in Ghana. And also when you go to the southern part of Ghana, there are a whole lot of flooding, especially in Accra and Kumasi. And all these are the causes of climate change. So I would say that climate change is rare in Ghana. And then we are trying as much as possible to see how we can combat against the climate change in Ghana by maybe trying to do more sensitization in the communities, in the schools, and also in some organizations in Ghana, and also planting more trees. Because when we plant more trees, then we can take a lot of carbon, excess carbon in the atmosphere. And then this tender storm, and then high temperature, and then extension of the drought and everything will also go down. So our main focus is on the tree planting exercise, where each and everyone in the community is also trying to do his or her best in the community and then in Ghana.
That's wonderful. And, you know, I've seen how, for instance, the shea butter trees then lead to women having an income, but also combating the desertification.
Yeah.
So it's a beautiful work. Thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.
And maybe just to complete, if there's any message that you would like to send to other communities and community builders around the planet at this time.
Okay. What I want to tell other communities is that climate change is rare. So we have to do our best so that we can fight against climate change. And also, we also have to try as much as possible to create more jobs for our people and for the youth. And also see how we can also generate our own income. We shouldn't wait for money from anywhere. So when we are financially sustainable, that is what can help us to move forward in the land that God has given to us. So thank you very much.
Thank you. And it's thank a beautiful message of hope and dignity that you carry.
Thank you.
Thank you, Paul.
Thank you, Kosha.